what's up? This is St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com, getting ready for NAMM. What type of stuff are you hearing? What type of stuff do you want to know about? What type of rumors? What stuff are you interested in? For me, I'm really interested in a lot of the hardware that's coming out or supposed to be coming out, and I'm just interested in seeing a lot of new synthesizers, a lot of analog synthesizers. We've seen Moog and a Sub Fatty, which I'm definitely want to check that out. But Korg's supposed to be coming out with like an MS-20, a mini version, which would be cool. Also a VA synthesizer with some CV stuff and some tube stuff going on in it. Kurzweil's kind of hitting that, coming out with something new. I don't know if it's going to be a workstation or a piano or whatever it's going to be, but that would be cool. Don't know if Yamaha's doing anything. Been hearing some rumblings about Roland. One of the things that I'm personally probably at the top of my list that I would like to see, that I've been hearing rumors about for a long time, that I think that is actually going to be there this year, would be a new MV. I personally have the 8800, and I think that the MV is probably one of the best hardware workstations created. Of course, when it was created, technology made things just a little tad bit slower, stuff like that, but in terms of the workflow, in terms of what they were doing in the actual workstation, it was really, really ahead of the game. So it would be interesting to see where they would take it if they brung it out again and, you know, revamped it and did something new. So I'm definitely going to check out and see if they got that. I hope they do, because like I said, I've been hearing about it for a while, but who knows? Presonus got a bunch of stuff coming out. Maybe it's some interfaces, maybe some controllers, maybe a bigger fader port. I don't know, but you know, we'll go over there and check that out. I expect to see a lot of stuff for like the iPad, like controllers and, you know, interfaces. I hear Apogee's got an interface for the iPad. So I just expect to see a lot of new hardware stuff. I mean, I'm interested in some software stuff. Probably the main software person I'm interested in would be Spectrasonics, to see if they do something new or do something updated to their stuff, because their stuff is just killer. But also Bitwig, I want to check them out, see what they're doing. They'll be there. But yeah, mainly for me, I'm interested in a lot of hardware. And of course, the stuff that's not announced, the stuff that we know nothing about, that we've heard nothing about, you know, the smaller boutique synth providers and hardware makers and just the smaller companies that don't announce stuff and wait till you get there. So I'm looking to be surprised, see a lot of stuff. And of course, if you guys got anything you want me to check out, make sure you let me know. Make sure you keep a lot to the YouTube channel, youtube.com/soundsandgear. Also, make sure you check out the NAMM page, nam.soundsandgear.com. And Flux will be there again. You know, we went crazy last year, so make sure you check out his site too. He'll be doing some updates as well at fluxwithit.com. So make sure you check that stuff out. Let us know if there's any specific things you want to hear about, want us to find out about, want us to look into, interfaces, controllers, hardware, software, whatever. Let us know, and we'll go see what we can find out. So let me know what you're thinking about, what you're interested in, and yeah, let's have fun. I'll see y'all later. This is St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com. Peace.